I'm Pastor Joe, and I'm really glad to have you on my channel. Today we're going to talk about the five things you need to do to lead your small group effectively. I don't know if you're new to leading a small group or you just want to make your small group experience better, but if you've been called to lead a small group or you think you might be wanting to lead a small group, this is the place for you to be. If you like my content, please be sure to subscribe using the link below. The first step in a successful small group experience is the personal prayer of preparation. It's not your power or my power or John Piper's power that's going to convert people, help them share, and create a community experience. It's going to be the Holy Spirit. So spend some time before the Lord, asking for you to be able to hear the Holy Spirit, be listening to Him, and then be obedient and submitted to the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit's going to be the one to give you that nudge when to press in a little further, or maybe when to back off, or when you need to call or text somebody later. Number two, the space your small group is in. It needs to be comfortable and it needs to be safe. Let's talk about comfort. For a space to be comfortable, I think it needs to be clean and not distracting. So start by taking anything that could be distracting or offensive or just not helpful out of the space you're gonna be in to create a clean look. And then have some food. Jesus's ministry was always based around food. When people realize there's gonna be no deficits in the area they're in, there's gonna be no shortage, no need, they're automatically more comfortable and more relaxed. So have some food, have some beverages, and keep the space comfortable. The space also needs to be safe. By safe, I mean you're gonna have to be willing to maybe vet who comes to your small group. There might be someone who's toxic or abusive, and they shouldn't be at your small group. Also, be prepared to head off comments. If someone is sarcastic or using humor, most likely they're covering up a hurt of their own, but to deal with that hurt later effectively, first, the space has to be safe for everyone. So make sure there's some clear boundaries and that everyone can feel safe to share in the space. Number three, the topic of your small group. You might think this should have been number one because it's the most pressing to you, but let me just say anything you choose to talk about in your small group, as long as it's from the Bible, it will be a successful small group. The Word of God is powerful. It is sharper than any two-edged sword, and all of it is profitable for teaching and for studying and for meditating. Anything you choose from the Bible will be great. The problem comes when you try to vary your small group topics off of the Bible. Be careful with videos. Videos have a way of taking away that human connection and focus on each other and moving everyone into more of a spectator place where they're just watching something happen instead of participating in it themselves. Now, maybe if you've got a successful small group running and everyone there is really good at sharing and discussing and talking, you could have some shorter videos, but keep the video short and the human interaction the main thing. Also, if you're using a book to study through, hopefully that book is basing most of its ideas and principles off of Scripture. So make sure you take time to look up those verses, look up the context of the verses mentioned in the study book, and it's okay to use a study book. Just make sure that the Bible is the main course of what your small group is talking about. Fourth, you are a facilitator. Don't think of yourself as a leader. Don't think of yourself as a teacher. And don't put the pressure on yourself to know everything. I think the number one job of a successful small group facilitator is to make sure that everyone gets a chance to share. You're gonna find people that are going to shy back and not say anything. And you're gonna have other people that won't stop sharing. Make sure you take the time as a facilitator to just guide the discussion on a good path and go around the room. Draw out the introverts, draw out the shy ones that don't want to share, and maybe tame down the ones that do want to share, maybe a little too much. Just facilitate a healthy, balanced discussion. And number five, group prayer. Group prayer is essential to a successful small group. Now there's two rules you need to remember when you're talking about group prayer. Number one, everything is confidential. What happens in the small group stays in the small group. Maybe touch base with each other during the week if there's a specific, intense prayer request that needs to be covered or followed up on. But make sure everyone knows that this is a safe place and that what happens in the small group is going to stay confidential. Secondly, don't let anyone cop out on their prayer requests. You'll find as a small group facilitator that there will be people that when you ask them what their prayer request is, maybe they pray for school or for their Aunt Betty's medication as she goes to the doctor, or maybe they want their car to be fixed, but they won't actually tell you how are they feeling. Jesus says that we are the branches on Him, the vine, and that we're constantly being pruned so that we can grow more. What I like to tell people is that God is developing fruit in your life. What is it? And if you don't know what fruit God is developing in your life, find out. That's a great place to start with small group. It also means that God is going to be pruning some things out of our lives. So maybe as a facilitator, you need to take a minute to think about these things for yourself. But encourage people to tell you, what fruit is God growing in your life? What does He want in your spirit? What is the Holy Spirit guiding them to do? And what things do they need to prune? What things need to leave their life? What things are weights in the race before them? And I got one bonus point for you, and that is group worship. Make sure your small group is able to worship together. And if you can at all, learn a new song together that no one in the group knows. Just pick a good, gospel-rooted, rich theological song to learn together as a small group. And if no one plays an instrument, that's what YouTube is for. Look up the music and sing it together. But nothing gets a small group together like worshiping together. I'm Joe Inslee, and those were the 5 things you need to know, plus a bonus, to successfully lead a small group as a small group facilitator. If you like my content, please be sure to like, subscribe, and share with your friends.